The reason why that fear is instilled, I mean, it's given to us so that we don't do really stupid things like that that are going to cause us to die, right? It's going to cause us to foolishly lose our life. There are certain fears like that that's not what I'm talking about. And that's not what the Bible's talking about when it's talking about the sin of being fearful. You know, those things make sense. The intention of fear is to inhibit your actions. That is what fear is supposed to do. That's what it does. It stops you. It inhibits you from doing things. The problem is when we allow fear to inhibit us from doing things that God wants us to do. So if God has a way that we're supposed to live our life, God has things that's designed for you to do, that he wants you to do, he commands you to do, but then when you let fear come in and take over and you end up not doing those things because you're afraid, that is where the sin sets in. Now, I have many different fears that can impact us and biblical examples of these fears, and I want to kind of approach them individually because you may be struggling in one area and not in another, and I want to kind of make sure that we're covering all these various types of fears that you may come across that we ought not to have. We started off here in Mark chapter number 4, and I'm going to be looking, we're going to be focusing in on the latter part of this chapter when the disciples are in a ship, they're in a boat. Now try to put yourself in that situation. If you're out at sea and you're out at one of these boats. Now, this isn't like if you've only been in a boat in like Arizona. It's nothing like that what we're talking about here. Okay, we have like ponds here. we have little tiny puddles that like you could swim across and you know what I mean? And there's a few lakes that are a little bit bigger, okay, granted. But these are not the seas typically that we're reading about in the Bible. You go out into these boats, you have these real big storms, these tempests where you have these huge waves coming in. And in this example, what's happening is that the waves are so big and the ship's being tossed so much, the waves are literally coming over the boat and like into the boat and kind of filling the boat up with water. That's what's happening here. So this is not some real trivial thing or some light thing or just, oh, there's not a boat, like you have no reason to be afraid. There is a lot of reason for them to be fearful in a situation like that. If you put yourself in that situation, you could only imagine, I could definitely see why they would be fearful, okay? It's not right, and we'll see that in a minute, but you can understand why when you put yourself in that position. Let's look at verse number 37. The Bible reads, "And there arose a great storm of wind, and the waves beat into the ship," not just on the ship, but into the ship, "so that it was now full." The ship is full of water from the waves beating into the ship. "And he was in the hinder part of the ship," talking about Jesus. You got this great storm, the waves are blowing in, and there's Jesus asleep on a pillow. Right? So he's just taking a nap, you know, getting some rest. Not a big deal. He doesn't care about it at all. "And they awake him and say unto him, Master, carest thou not that we perish?" They're like, don't you even care? We're about to die here in the middle of this storm. "And he arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, Peace, be still. And the wind ceased and there was a great calm." So they come to him. They're all scared. They're worried. They're fearful. And he takes care of the problem for them. He says, okay. Peace, peace. You know, imagine that, just being in the boat with them when you're in the middle of this huge storm and then it just stops because Jesus said so. Just done. That's amazing. And that's why the reaction, look at verse number 40, "And he said unto them, Why are you so fearful? How is it that you have no faith? And they feared exceeding." I mean, this was like, now they're even fearing even more because Jesus has power over the wind and the rain and the storm. It says, "And they said one to another, What manner of man is this that even the wind and the sea obey him?" Witnessing the true power of God among them, that makes them fear even more. Now, having a healthy fear of the Lord, actually, that is a good thing. So when you read through the Bible, you're going to see, you know, we saw in Revelation 21:8, you know, the fearful is a sin. We're going to see here, Jesus rebukes them. He says, "Why are ye so fearful? How is it that you have no faith?" Oftentimes, what we're going to see is that the problem with being fearful is a lack of faith. Faith is something you believe in, but you can't see. It's you're believing in kind of a, it's not an unknown, but it's unseen, right? And the reason why in this situation, I think especially Jesus can rebuke them and they shouldn't have been fearful is because Jesus was right there with them. Okay, there are times in your life when you could get in a situation where if Jesus isn't with you, you have a lot more reason to fear. But if you are living the righteous life, if you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, if you're following and obeying God's commandments, I'll tell you right now, you have nothing to fear. You have zero reason to fear when these events, these external events, these life events that happen. Now look, you may never get into a boat and say, well, that's not going to happen to me. Well, let's look at this a little bit more symbolically. I mean, when you find yourself in life in the middle of a big tempest and a big storm, you've got turmoil, you've got chaos, you've got all kinds of things going on in your life around you that end up making you real fearful. Maybe you got some big medical storm. Maybe you've got some big family storm going on and it's scary and it's beating you down. If you're with Jesus, or if Jesus is with you, you have no reason to fear.